Hi everyone, I'm Ben from the Merrimack Public Library, and this is If You Know, You Know, Kitchen Survival. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to make soft pretzel bites. These are a great snack that are kind of like the soft pretzels you'd get at like a mall food court or something like that. And you can make them really simply with mostly pre-bought ingredients, which is a plus. We're also going to cover how to do a really quick cheese dip if you want some cheese dip to go with your pretzels. So, let's get down to it. All right, so before we get going, I've got my oven preheating to 350 degrees, and we've got all our ingredients set out. The main thing we're going to be using to make our pretzels is some pre-made pizza dough. This is just the store's own brand. You could also use Pillsbury or whatever pre-made pizza dough you've got handy. We're also going to need an egg, some salt. If you've got rock salt, that'll be like the big crunchy kind. That'll be even more like a mall soft pretzel, but this is kosher salt, which is kind of flaky, which will get the job done just fine. And the last thing we're going to need for our pretzel bites is to get the browning on the outside, we're going to want a bath of water and baking soda. So I've got 1 quart or 4 cups of warm water here, and 1 1/3 cups of baking soda. And I'm going to make a bath of the two. So, you know, I keep adding your baking soda in here and make sure it all gets combined. Ooh, I don't have enough room in my vessel for this. All right, so once you've figured out any issues with the size of your container and mixed together your warm water and your baking soda, you should get a mixture that looks sort of like this. You may need to periodically give it another stir to make sure the baking soda stays mixed into the water. And we're ready to start with our dough. So I've got a parchment lined baking sheet right here to deposit the dough onto. And what we're going to do is we're going to take off bits of our pizza dough and get a bite-sized piece and dip it into our baking soda and water bath. You can tear or cut as you like. I'm gonna get my size bit. I'm gonna use a fork here, give it a good dip, and throw it on our baking sheet here. And if you're having a hard time getting the dough to go, you can cut it with a knife or some kitchen safe shears. If it's sticking too much, a quick dip in the baking soda and water bath will actually make it stop sticking quite so badly. All right, so now that we've got all of our dough cut up into bite-sized pieces and dipped in the baking soda water bath, we're gonna give them an egg wash, which will make the outside a little glossier. So we're just gonna take one egg and beat it and once you've got that pretty well homogeneous, you're just going to give this a quick your dough a quick brush down over the top with the egg. Once you're done with that, you can sprinkle on some salt, which should adhere to the egg. And you can, of course, change this based on how salty you like your pretzel to be. And if you wanted to make like a sweet pretzel instead, you could swap this salt out for maybe like cinnamon sugar or something like that, which could just be a couple parts of sugar to one part of cinnamon mixture, or if you have any other spice combinations you wanted to try, you could do those instead, and this would be a good time to add them where it'll have something to stick to on the outside of your pretzel. these are all set to go into the oven. All right, so these are gonna go onto the oven for about 12 minutes or until they're golden brown. So maybe set the timer a minute or two short of 12 minutes and just keep an eye on them. While our pretzels are in the oven, we have time to whip up our cheese sauce. So this is a really simple cheese sauce recipe that's easy to customize. All we're gonna need is a little bit of flour, a little bit of butter, a little bit of milk, some optional salt, and our choice of cheese. And for this, I'm just using some cheddar. So the first thing we're gonna do is shred 4 ounces, which will just be about half of this brick of cheddar, using our box grater. This is a great thing. You can combine multiple kinds of cheeses if you want. I'm just using cheddar. And the reason we're shredding our own cheese for this, you could certainly use pre-shredded cheese, but most of the time, pre-shredded cheese has some anti-caking stuff to stop the cheese from sticking together and making clumps in the bag, and it makes it so that it won't melt as nicely. So if you want to get more of a sauce-like consistency, better to shred your own. And no worries if some bits break off, because it's all going to be melting anyway. We just ideally would like it to get into small pieces so it'll melt a little faster. Looks like that's right about half. Yeah. So now we can go do the rest of this over on the stove. All right, so over here on the stove, we're going to make a what's called a roux, which is basically just an equal amount of flour and butter. And it's a good way to make a base for any sort of a creamy cheese sauce. So we're gonna start this out over medium heat. We're gonna get a tablespoon of butter heated till it's foaming. Let that go for a second. All right, so now that our butter is bubbling, we can add our flour. We've got, again, a tablespoon to go with our tablespoon of butter. Just gonna sort of sprinkle that in here. We want to whisk constantly until it mixes together and we're left with no lumps. It's the main thing we want. We're going to get a paste to come together. We want to make what's called a blonde roux, which will be just barely starting to brown at all. That's there, we can start to stream in some milk slowly. We've got a half cup of milk here. You can use whole milk is recommended. I think you can probably use others. You just want to go a little at a time, and you want to whisk together until that leaves no lumps, and then you can add a little more. And keep going. And a little more. And if this at any point doesn't work out and you do end up with some lumps, it's still going to be fine. It just won't be quite as smooth of a final sauce. starting to form sort of a thicker consistency, which is what we wanted to see here. Adding some more of our milk. Lower our temperature maybe a little to medium low. And we want to let this come up to a simmer and start to thicken up a little more. So we'll leave this on medium low until it's simmering for a minute or two. Yeah, so you can even go a little lower if it's starting to bubble a hair more than we want. We want just a few, yeah, that's about where we want it to be, I think. Once this is thickened up to about where we want it, and it's been simmering for a minute or two, we can take it off the heat, and we can bring our cheese in. And stir that to get it to melt. If you want to add any other flavors, this would be a good time to do that. You can add a couple dashes of hot sauce if you like it spicier. You could do like some bits of jalapeno or like peppers. You can add a touch of salt at this point if you give it a taste and it seems like it needs more salt. This would be a good time to add your salt. Just give that mix, and then you'll have, and of course if you like this any thinner, you could probably add a little more milk to it. And just keep stirring until all your cheese is dissolved, and this will solidify if left at room temperature for too long, so best to eat it hot. But if it does get too solid, or you need to refrigerate it and save it for another use, you can zap it for like 30 seconds at a time in the microwave to heat it back up. And that should work out. And this will go great on, you know, any of your things you like cheese sauce for, you know, vegetables, etc. And yeah, we're just about all done. Alright, so here we are with our pretzels ready to come out of the oven. This took a little longer than 12 minutes, but what else is new? So we've got them right about where we want them, nice golden brown. Make it a little darker after we take them out. And ready to eat them. Alright, and here we have it, our pretzels and cheese dip. As you can see, these came out a little paler than I might have liked. I think maybe the trick is to keep them more on the small size and make sure you really get them well coated with the egg and baking soda mixture, but they're really tasty and the cheese sauce is nice and cheesy and stretchy, and it's a nice quick snack recipe that I hope you'll try for yourselves. So there you have it, a nice quick recipe for pretzel bites that doesn't require you to learn how to make pretzel dough yourself. And also a good, nice, simple recipe for cheese dip that you can modify however you like. I hope everyone tries this out. Let us know if you come up with any variations. If you like to put something spicy in your cheese dip, or maybe do like cinnamon pretzels instead of regular salty pretzels. And if you have any other things you'd like to see us do on this show, drop a comment down below and maybe we'll get to it in a future episode. But until next time, I've been Ben from the Merrimack Public Library. Bye!